ITI today is equipped with 7 major sections, of which 3 are SWEDAC accredited, while 4 are accredited by SLAB. The staff members too have risen to approximately 400. This being said, in keeping with our vision to be a regional center for excellence in scientific and industrial research for national development, and our mission to conduct innovative research and development and provide internationally competitive technical services to accelerate industrial development for the benefit of the people of Sri Lanka. We are committed to achieve the highest level of customer satisfaction and continuous improvement of services by meeting the requirements quality system as per ISO 17025 for the technical services and ISO 9000 for quality management. With the assistance of this LCMS-MS instrument, I am confident that ITI will be able to cater to a significant number of clients covering a much broad area. Sir, the area that could be covered and the usage of this instrument will be explained to you by Dr. Manoj Pille, who will address to you in a mile. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish you an informative and a pleasant evening. Thank you.
I want to thank the organizers of this meeting for providing me with a learning experience. The last I heard of the work you were doing was when you were called the CISIR. And I remember for a very short time, many years ago, I was the Minister of Higher Education and I visited CSIR, and Dr. Mubarak was good enough to take me round and show me the work that was going on. So my first responsibility is to thank each and every one of you, because though you may have performed a silent service, you have performed a very, very vital service to the industrial growth of this country. Sri Lanka is in a transitional phase, that is, from being a primarily agricultural country, which depended on domestic agriculture as well as commercial agriculture. We are transiting, like most developing countries, into a technologically oriented economy. In some countries, this takes a long time. In some other countries, it's much shorter. But whether we like it or not, economic growth today demands that we focus attention on the industrial sector, on our export sector, and generally creating a culture of science in this country. I cannot say that we have got there at present, but I am encouraged by the fact that we have a large scientific community in this country. Through our university system, through training abroad, through various courses that you have attended, both here and outside, we have created a large scientific community. And if you look at this group as against the other service groups or professional groups in the country, I think everybody will say that you have done a grand job. With very limited resources, you have made use of your knowledge and elevated the level of production in this country, whether it be by giving ISO status or advice or testing out some of the equipment. In very multifarious ways, you have helped in creating a science culture in this country. I think we cannot go forward if we cannot transit from our traditional cultural approaches to a more scientific and a modernist one. Because today there is very strong competition, especially in the industrial and export sector. If you have the money, you can get that equipment. Doesn't matter where you are. Equipment is freely available across borders. Knowledge is freely available across borders. So we live in a different world. And I'm happy to say that our scientific community, with limited resources, have made a great effort to keep abreast of scientific developments and apply as much of it as possible to our requirements. Successive governments have become or have begun to realize the value of this culture of science. I must say, when CISIR was started, about that time probably this was only a small island of scientific knowledge in a large area of other professional and other training and evaluation professions. But your role has grown. Now this has to be linked to our industrial production and exports. We are having a crisis in Sri Lanka, in the sense that, especially following the open market policies, that today every country has transited to a market economy. There's no country that is not transiting or has already transited to a market economy. 30, 40 years ago, there were national economies, there were communist economies, there were ideas like Fortress France, where the French economy, though it was open, could be still within their own physical boundaries. There were different concepts at that time. But today we have moved to a market economy. That is a fact of life. Best example is India, China. Those large societies are becoming science-oriented and market-oriented. So how do we evaluate your performance in terms of encouraging research which will help us to boost our industrial capacity? The industrial capacity is not enough to survive in terms of our domestic market. That is another aspect. When the CISIR was formed, your advice was to various companies which were primarily interested in addressing the demand in the local market. I can remember it, the nascent industries. You gave them a helping hand. They would come to you for some research, to improve their technology. I can give some examples, I can remember. And each one of them were helped by you. But that was in a tight domestic demand-driven economy. But today we are in a different world where it's a highly competitive industrial scenario. So each country will develop its own spheres of specialization where they have comparative advantage. In economics now, the key word is comparative advantage. How do you develop your resources to exploit or maximize the advantages we have in our country, in our territory, in our industries? So keeping in mind this comparative advantage, we have to select those particular industrial ventures, those particular exports, which will make use of the information that you give us. If you help them, if you guide them, then they will be better located, better situated to enter into this highly competitive industrial market. So it's a different scene and you have to help. I know that many industrialists at certain times, I have held many portfolios, I can't even remember which is which. When you look, I was in charge of industries at one stage, exports at another stage, investment at another stage. Each of these, they come up with problems. One of the problems they said, I must tell you frankly, I'm not talking of you, but in the history of CI, that you all were taking too much of time. That they give some product to be analyzed, to be classified, or I don't know what, some sort of certification or whatever. And then they used to come and complain that, you know, this takes a long time. By this time, our competitors have beaten us to it. So today it's important because now I see that some of those factors, some of it may be within your control, let me put it nicely that way. Those are within your control, but some other factors are not within your control. Like not having proper equipment, not having access to the latest equipment. Some, to be globally competitive, where is the hardware which you can use to give that service? So today you are addressing that issue. I'm glad that you have got the advice of Dr. Pillai. He will explain all this, and you have got the machinery so that we upgrade the technology in your institution to provide that other service. Otherwise, it's useless blaming you. Otherwise, always people come and say, this is getting delayed, we are not getting the proper estimation, all sorts of things like that. But the answer to that is not to go on complaining about it, but to get the modern technology you need to address those issues. I was very impressed, for example, by the Nanotechnology Institute. I think many of you have visited that. The type of equipment they have, the type of dedication, the type of support also. Unless you have the support of your sponsors, be it the government or private sector, to address your needs very fast, then it is not fair to blame the scientists who are involved for delays and inaccuracy and so on, unless you get the equipment. So this is a good eye-opener for me. It's a good eye-opener for all of us to see that we must all link up our efforts, and it's our responsibility to see that you get the resources you need to carry out your job. The resources that were available when CISIR was started were limited. And I think, if I'm correct, it was Mr. Philip Gunawardhan who was very, very interested in, and Mr. William Silva during that time, who were very interested in setting up this industrial evaluation. At that time, they were thinking more of the local, as I began saying, in local products. How to improve the rubber industry? How to improve the tea industry? How do you improve fisheries? That sort of thing. But now we have gone on to a broader spectrum where your services are required. I don't want to go into all those, and I'm not a specialist, as I think you would have found out by now. I want to give the opportunity to your chief guest to address you. But I do want to say that we appreciate your commitment, and though it is a silent service, it is a very vital service for economic growth in this country. So thank you very much, and I'm happy to meet you as the minister responsible. Thank you very much.
SciEx is a global leader in mass spectrometry. We deal in this instrumentations, LC-MS, MS, after-sales service support, workflows, and software. SciEx is a company which has more than 20 years of experience in LC-MS, MS.
So how do we identify and make sure that the honey is free of antibiotics? LC-MS comes into as a savior for this. Now let us look at another one which you have faced recently, milk. It is a wonderful health contribution food where there are a lot of natural minerals, vitamins, etc. are present, but corrupted milk. This is one of the report comes from China, how melamine got into China's dairy products. It has become a big news in the industry, and it has affected many people there, and also in the pet industry. Another one which has happened in Sri Lanka here, it's the DCD or diacinamide contamination in the milk.
Great honor and privilege for me to be called upon the proposed vote of thanks on behalf of Industrial Technology Institute in this occasion of launching LCMS-MS. Actually, we are extremely grateful to the Honorable Minister of Higher Education and Research, Dr. Sarath Amunugama, for being with us in this occasion. Actually, his presence in today's function is a source of great encouragement to all of us. We are extremely grateful to Mr. Ranipura, the Secretary to the Ministry of Higher Education and Research, for your presence.